this session, we are using sugar to make snacks. And we are going to make two types, the sweetened and the savory. The savory one, you normally call it inkatiaboga or coated granules. So the ingredients are, we have the granules, as the raw granules. Then we are adding a pinch of salt. A pinch of nutmeg. Then sugar. Then you have to stir. Then you break an egg into a plate to find out if it is fresh. This one also goes into the granules and stir. Make sure all the granules they are wet. They are being coated by the egg. Make sure everything is wet. Then after this, you sprinkle a little flour and also make sure all the granules are being coated. Use enough flour so that the egg the granules will separate. They shouldn't stick together because of the egg. Then after everything has been coated on the sugar, on the granules, then repeat the process again. Just add a little salt. Then the sugar and the pinch of nutmeg. Then you stir again. After that, you break another egg into the plate. Then you add it to the granules, the already coated granules. Make sure all the granules should be coated with the egg. After this, you sprinkle flour so that the granules which has been coated with the egg should separate. The granules which have been coated with the egg will separate. They shouldn't stick together. So you should use enough flour for this purpose, or else after frying you can see that the beans stick together. It shouldn't be that way. So if the coating is not enough, then you have to repeat the process again. If the coating is not enough for you, you can also repeat the process by adding the salt, sugar, nutmeg, the egg, and the flour as well. So if the coating is all right, then you allow it to dry a little before being fried. After the second coating, make sure you try to remove the coating from the granite. If it peels off easily, it means it's not done. But if it takes a longer period, it means it's done. This one, you can see this what was being removed from the granite. This what was removed from the granite. So if you compare this, this is the one that I removed. So if you look at the coating very well, then you try to peel. It's not easy to, peeling. It's not easy peeling. Mm-hmm. So when I peel, everything comes out. Even the shell, the skin of the granules comes out. So this is how you can tell if it is well coated or not. So after coating, make sure you place it into a flat container or any container. Make sure they are being dried before being fried. Don't fry it straight away. So we allow it. If you don't take care, it will not, you won't get the best result. That's why you have to allow it to dry up. So after coating, you can see that it has increased. The quantity has really increased. So these ones are being fried. So we allow it to rest a little before they are being fried, so that the egg will dry up a little on it. And after frying, you get the best result. For the sweetened groundnuts, you use the same quantity of the groundnuts and the sugar. This one is going to be cooked in a syrup, sugar solution. The same quantity of water, then a teaspoon of a cinnamon powder. Then stir. This one is going onto the fire to continue with the cooking. So this one will be on fire until all the water has been evaporated and the sugar coats the granules. So we need a bigger pan, because as it cooks, the water will go into the cells of the granules and it will swell up. So if you use a smaller pan, it will have a space for expansion. The sugar, the bubbles of the sugar has changed. So it means the cooking has reached a certain stage. So now it become a bit sticky than we started. So make sure you don't leave it on fire or else it will burn. You stir always. So when you get to a certain stage, the bubbles will also reduce. The boiling will reduce. So, and the sugar and the liquid will disappear, and the sugar will coat the granules. the bubbles have reduced a little, and the sugar has become a bit sticky. So it's not coating the groundnuts. So you stir, it's still not ready. You have to take time for it to coat, become so that it can stay. It shouldn't stick together. It should stay. At this stage, you need to stir, or else they will stick. And cinnamon to also help those who are being stressed up. At this stage, it's taken together, so it needs to be stirred. It needs to be stirred. And it's better to be cooked in a non-stick pan. If it's aluminium, if you don't take it, everything will stick into the bottom of the pan. So if you can get a non-stick one, that will be the best, a non-stick pan. Can see that it has increased in quantity. Now it has changed into a different form. Now it's no more wet, it's becoming dry. It's becoming dry, so it means it's near to the end of the quantity has really increased. So now it's dry. Everything has dried up. The liquid, the syrup has dried up. So it's left only left with the sugar and the granules. But you still continue stirring. The color and everything has changed. After some time, you saw that the sugar was dry, but now it has melted and forms on the granules. So now it's ready. And when it's almost to the end, you can hear a sound. It means it's on its way to the finishing point. Now it's ready. Now it's because of the sugar, if you overcook, it will burn. Now it's ready. So we are going to put on a big tray so that air will pass through, so that it does not stick.